Someone always has to take the first step in pioneering something, and it's okay. Sandbox, you know, we're all about the law of large numbers. We think taking risk is part of what we do now. Success breeds success. We've had some good success stories here, and they continue to emerge. All over the country, there are tens of thousands of entrepreneurs sitting in their homes, their garages, and classrooms, thinking about starting companies. If we could simply enable those people to come out, give them some early stage angel funding, help them understand what it's like to start a business, I think that's really good for America. Anytime there's a place for these people to go, whether it's an incubator or an accelerator or a program like Accelerate or Techstars, the fact that there's a place for them to go with their idea is a good thing. Those are just emerging over the last 5 years, and they'll probably continue to emerge. Being able to work with to be able to work alongside people, to not make the same mistakes that everybody makes over and over again, make new ones, is a good thing. So this is Sandbox. This is where we try to create businesses, where we invest in businesses. Usually this is a very crowded space, but it's pretty early in the morning here. So we like to have a big, open, collaborative environment where people can work together, talk together, make it easy, brainstorm. A lot of our ideas come from spontaneous brainstorms, so you want to have a space conducive to that. One of the things I really want to probe with new companies is, do they have the fortitude it takes to stay with a business? Because there's going to be a lot of pitfalls, and there's going to be a lot of up and down cycle, and you have to be able to stay with it. You have to be able to pivot. You have to be able to try new things. It's really important to not be blind and say, I'm going to take this idea and I'm going to run through that wall with it. Those attributes are good, and they occasionally work. But for every one of those, there's a thousand that fail. So you have to be flexible enough to pivot. I think my advice would be, seek out either a board member or an investor or another mentor to help you through that process. In my opinion, there's a lot about staying the course and hiring great people. One thing I think entrepreneurs make the mistake of sometimes is not doing the age-old proven technique of hiring people smarter than themselves. I've done that my whole career, and I've tried to do that, and I continue to today.
I'm very proud to introduce our next speaker, a friend and someone I've known for years, someone who is committed to creating an environment in Chicago where new businesses can be created, someone who has a passion for using technology to help people in their everyday lives, someone who shares a couple things with the Accelerate group, serious financial funding issues in front of them, and a whirlwind last 100 days, our mayor, Rahm Emanuel.